The nonprofit funded for the Arts Council, Macon County, Bobby Candino.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor and Board. I'm Bobby Candino. I work for the Arts Council. Our president, Cindy Miles, had to be in Raleigh with the senior legislature tonight, so she couldn't be with us. I had hoped she'd make the presentation this year. You must get tired of seeing me. The sheet that's coming around is a listing of all of the programs that the Arts Council produced last year from July 1st, 2009 to June 30th, 2010. All of those programs were produced and delivered here in Franklin. And with our proposal, I sent a narrative describing our amazing volunteer involvement. And we can't really count the people that we reach, because if you come to the town festivals, and I've seen many of you at the town festivals, we're always there. We were at the Latino Fest last month. We're at the Pumpkin Fest. We're at the Taste of Scotland with free children's arts activities. We do monthly workshops, themed workshops for kids. It's all free. We have all kinds of activities in the community. We do a lot of art reach, we call it. We go to all the nursing homes with music programs. We do weekly music programs at Macon Citizens for the Handicapped. We do sock hops for them. And if any of you have been to the fest, you know our sock hops. So we would like very much for the town to contribute $2,000 to these programs for the coming year. We do all that we can to raise money. In fact, this Saturday we're having a bazaar for the arts to try to raise some extra money. Our state funds, as everyone's state funds have been, were drastically cut last year, and we're having a slight reduction over that this year, and we don't know when they will be restored. And we understand that they're not targeting the arts. Everybody's getting less money for their programs and services. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them.
All right.
And we do have something I can tell Vanessa. I thought he used to show you some of our upcoming programs, but we're having the Boo Ball in the Mall at the Whistle Stop on Saturday, October 30th, and it's a daytime event for the kind of kids to come trick-or-treating and pop up, and they're doing pumpkin painting and coloring contests and things like that. We also, and I just brought every November, we have at the Rickman Store, the wonderful historic Rickman Store, we have an Art Saturday. This is our monthly kids' workshops, and we do a heritage holiday Art Saturday at the Rickman Store. And all that's free, and that's why we need your money. We deliver most of our programs free or for a donation. We don't want the arts to be available just to people with a lot of money in their pocket.
So. Now, I understand, I see the Macon County Schools is mentioning this. I understand a lot of the arts get cut out of schools.
Yes, sir. Well, and there's another example of, I don't believe they're targeting the arts. It's a matter of squeezing money. And they're in a real bind. One of the arts, the visual arts position at the Macon Middle School has been totally eliminated. So our seventh and eighth graders won't be getting any visual arts. And Tracy Clark Hagen, many of you may know Tracy, was the art teacher there. A wonderful, wonderful teacher. She had the kids doing amazing things. And when she applied for the job at the new Mountain View School and got it, she learned that her position at the middle school would not be filled, which is terribly unfortunate. Some of these kids are so talented, and that's a thing that they go to school for. But it's a matter of, you know, where do you put your funds? The drama, there's no drama at high school, and they have this wonderful drama program when Scotty Corbin was there. We're losing that, and we're doing what we can. We'll have the, you know, we bring artists into the school. We certainly cannot do anything like a full-time in-school teacher does. I mean, it's, you can't put a value on that. But we do, we'll be taking, we have a wonderful, wonderful guitar and cello duo. These guys are internationally known. They've won, Brad Richter, the guitarist, won the International Composer's First Prize a few years ago. We'll be taking them into the schools. We're taking jazz into the schools. We're trying to do what we can to foster our heritage arts, and we have a woman in Clyde who teaches the folk dancing and play dancing that the children used to do. And we do what we can. We certainly don't have enough money to bring enough arts in the schools to make up for these faculty positions that they're losing. And I don't know what the answer is.
About how many is active in your council?
Well, I don't know what you mean by active. Our membership is about 250 to 300. We have so many volunteers, and that's how, if you look at that list, now I'm a part-time director. I'm the only person that the Arts Council pays, and I make $13,000 a year, and nobody else gets paid to work on these programs. I mean, we pay our artists what we can, but we have a whole lot of volunteers, and we couldn't do this without them.
Right. Okay, questions, comments?
I so enjoy going to all the different programs and watching the kids and the adults. Everybody just really has a good time.
Thank you.
I think that it's a sad state of affairs when arts and anything like that's cut, particularly when some of the other things get increased funding. Mm-hmm. I think we should approve this request.
Is that a motion?
Absolutely.
I second.
Okay, we got further discussion? All in favor, raise your hand. This might be a, Mr. Greenwood and I and some others have talked about on our funding pool, the little debts that we have anymore, it seems like, that we may should, in our next budget year, consider a window of time of 90 days or thereabouts where we put out the word and get everybody pretty much an equal chance in that time frame to get their request in, so that we don't run the risk of getting people coming too late and getting too little who we really might have known and had we known they were coming. But this might be something for around budget time and next year to consider setting a policy such as that.
Okay.